Increasingly, modern businesses are looking to convert their digital assets, data, and services into a digital platform, and APIs are at the center of any platform. Many businesses are already doing this, with APIs as their primary way of doing business, folks like Twilio, SendGrid, and Stripe, whilst others look to add new revenue channels or new ways to engage with their customers. Azure API Management makes it easy for organizations of any size to publish APIs to partners, employees, and even the developer public at large. Using API Management in Azure couldn't be easier. I can come to the Azure portal and create a new instance of an API Management service, enter some details, choose the tier I want, and the region I'd like to deploy to, and in 10 or so minutes, I'll have a new instance of an API Management service up and ready to use. Here's one I created earlier called FAB API. And I can drill in and I can see a dashboard, I can scale the service and the number of instances, and I can configure custom domains, etc. right here in the Azure portal. To configure the details of my API Management service, I can go into our extra portal here by clicking this Management button. And this will allow me to add new APIs, add all of the metadata that's going to help me have a really successful API program. So what you can see here is our Azure API Management dashboard that gives me a heads-up view of all of my APIs, products, applications, and more. What I want to do now is show an example of how we can add all these management capabilities over an existing API in a matter of minutes. So I have an API I created earlier, and it's a simple calculator API that I hosted on Azure websites. And it allows me to add two numbers, so I can add a number simply by specifying a query string like so. So I'm going to add 4 and 4. I hit a post, and I will get a response that's a nice piece of XML that shows me the value of the response is 8, which is exactly what I'd expect. Now I've decided that I want to take this API and put it into the hands of developers so they can do something really innovative. And in order to have a successful API program, I need to have great documentation. I need to have an interactive experience that means that developers can get started super quickly. And I want analytics so I can see which APIs are being used the most, which developers are bringing in the most traffic and the most revenue, and really understand the health and performance of my API. So we've seen what the calculator API looks like. Let's go and add a new API to my API management service. So I'm going to call this the calculator API. Specify the underlying API, which is the one on websites that I just showed you. I'm going to give this a suffix of calc. Hit save, and in just a few seconds, that'll appear here, and we'll be able to edit some of the metadata for this particular API. So now I can go in and enter my settings. And this allows me to enter a number of things, including a description. Hopefully you'd have a more interesting API than a calculator, but you get the idea. This metadata is important because it's used to help us generate the dynamic documentation for your developers. So I'm going to save that change, and then let's go and add an operation. This operation is going to be the addition operation, and it was a post if you remember, so I enter post here. I enter my template, which was simply add A equals A and B equals B. So I'm specifying some parameters, A and B. Now, what I can do with API management is actually project a different facade for my API than the real back end. And in this case, what I'm going to do is take this query string version and I'm going to rewrite the URL to make it feel a little bit more modern. And I'm simply going to use those parameters to identify URL segments as such. So this is what the public API will look like, and this is what the actual backend looks like. Give this a name, so I'm going to say addition. I can enter a description, obviously again used for the documentation. I can turn on caching, so I can actually have API management cache responses from this API, and I can edit metadata about the parameters. So I can enter a description for each parameter, what the type is, for example a number, or if I want to be more specific, I can enter my own type. Let's enter a description for B. I can edit example values as well. Obviously, some numbers for integer, and we're good. I can also give an example of the body and a description of the post body. There isn't one in this case. and for different responses. So let's say I wanted to provide documentation for an error case where I send back a 500, then I can do that. Or let's just add something for a 200 OK in this case. Now, I can also document different representations. So we saw that the actual response from my service is text XML. So let's provide some example XML. And that would be added to my documentation. I can add different representations like application JSON, etc. So let's save that, and now my operation is ready. What I want to do next is actually make it so developers can access this operation and this API. And to do that, I make it part of a product so they can get a subscription to one of our products. Now, we have a number of products I've already entered here, 15-day free trial and unlimited. Products allow you to set things like expiration and whether developers can just sign up for this without your approval or whether you'd prefer to have the API publisher, that is me in this case, approve requests to use the API. I'm going to add a new product. I'm going to call this the public product. Anybody can sign up for this. And if I wanted to require approval, I'd just check this box here, but I don't, so I'm going to save that. And the next thing I need to do is just add my API here. So I'm going to add a new API to that, the calculator API, hit save. And then I want to publish that so it appears on our public developer portal. So now I'm ready, I've published my API, and now I can play the role of a developer. So a developer would actually find out about my API on our developer portal, which is right here. This is fully customizable, it's backed by a CMS, and you can change the look and feel of this to represent your own brand and identity. A developer arriving at this portal would choose the sign up button, would log in with either one of their social identities, Microsoft account, Facebook, Twitter, etc. Or they could create a custom account using their email address if they don't want to use a social identity. And then they could subscribe for products. So here we can see a list of the products. And as an administrator, I'm signed into the developer portal here, and I'm already signed up for these. So I'm just going to go straight into the API, and I'm going to take a look at my calculator API so you can see that metadata appearing here. So I drill into this. And here is my documentation that's being generated from that metadata. See how we have the URL, the format, and it's the projected format that we chose, some details about the parameters, the type, and the description that I provided. We can also use this metadata to generate code samples. So if I wanted to know how to call this API from a Ruby backend, for example, then it's as simple as clicking that Ruby button and then copying and pasting this code over into my application. Another thing is we do multiple languages here, so I can do JavaScript and C# as you would expect, but also even Objective-C for iOS developers. Here are some of the examples, so you can see I got some pretty printed XML that shows me what a 200 response looks like as an example. But perhaps best of all, we can also create an interactive console for developers to use. So by going into this console, I'll be able to interact with the API in real time and learn how to use it, which is critical to having a successful API program. So I'm going to enter a number here, 45, and then we'll put 10 in here. And now I need to specify the developer key that identifies me as a developer. I have a key for each subscription, and I have a primary and secondary key, as you'll be used to if you use the cloud. And I'm just going to choose my primary key here. The next thing I need to do is just hit post, and we'll invoke that API for real. And we see I got a response. I can see all of the headers that I got, see the latency of the service, and I can see the actual response as it came back from my API with that value of 55, which you would expect, 10 plus 45. So we're creating a great experience for developers here who want to use your API and have signed up via the API management experience. But we can do much more than this. We're collecting analytics, and we can change the behavior of your API. One thing I want to show you now is how we can configure policies to actually change how the API behaves. And I can set policies at a number of scopes, the scope of a product, an API, or an operation. I'm going to go and set one at our calculator API level. I'm going to add policy here. And what I'm going to do is actually in the outbound response, I'm going to convert XML to JSON. So I just need to configure some of these options. I'm going to go for a direct conversion, which I think produces the prettiest JSON. I'm going to always do the conversion as my choice. And I'm going to do it whether I'm not going to consider the accept header. I'm just going to send JSON back anyway. So let me just tidy this up. Hit save. And now that policy will be rolling out into effect for our API management service. And to test it, couldn't be easier. All I have to do is go back to my console, hit post, wait for the response to come back, and notice how this time I got a JSON response instead of XML without writing a single piece of code, just configuring a policy. We can do much more. Let me show you one more example of a cool and popular policy. So I'm going to go to my public product, and I've decided I want to protect my mission-critical system, this calculator API that I'm exposing to public developers. And what I'm going to do is add a rate limiting policy. So I'm going to add on the inbound here, I'm going to add a limit rate, a limit call rate. I'm going to set it for all of the APIs in that product. And I'm going to say you can only make 3 calls in every 60-second period. So I'm going to save that, and that's going to be rolled out into the live API proxies that are running the that are hosting the API management service. And then I switch back over to the developer console. I'm going to hit post, and you see we got a 200. Hit post again, we got a 200. Hit post again, we got a 200. Hit post again, I got a 429, too many requests. And if I go and look at the body of that, we'll see rate limit is exceeded, try again in 55 seconds. If we switch back to the management experience and go and take a look at our analytics, we'll be able to see some of the traffic that's been hitting our API. So you can see that we've had, let's see, in the last few minutes since we launched the service, we've had 6 calls, a response time around 156 milliseconds, and a bandwidth of just under 3K. So hopefully you get the impression of just how powerful API management is. There's much more that it can do out of the box, and you can do it in no time at all. Thanks.